Furniture design workshop. In this semester, we will talk about all the different materials that are used in furniture, like wood, metal, and glass. We will discuss all the properties of these individual materials. And then we will also study what furniture designs and what finishes are possible in all of these materials. So for the first topic, we will start with wood. Wood is the most common and the most obvious material that we see in furniture. Almost all of our furniture is either made out of wood or metal, or maybe a composition of these. And a lot of them have a finishing of glass or addition of glass in their design as well. But when we think of furniture, we think of wooden furniture first, and then the rest of the materials start coming to our mind. So we will start with this. Wood is available to us to be used in furniture in a lot of different forms. We have solid wood, which is a processed trunk of all different types of trees that are used in woodwork and furniture making. So that is solid wood. Then you have a hardwood. Hardwood is basically, if we seal wood fibers together with adhesives, steam and pressure, it becomes this board that is basically made out of residual wood processed materials. So this is, hardwood is mostly used in parts of furniture that we don't see, like the inside of drawers, the dividers, maybe the bottom of a piece of furniture or back panels that is not usually visible on the outside of the furniture. Then we have a particle board. Particle board is made of wood particles and adhesive. It is formed by flat pressing, extrusion, or mat forming. The thickness of particle boards vary from 1/8 of an inch to 2 inches, and they come in different sizes. So particle board, because it is made out of wood particles, it doesn't have a grain. What is the grain? Okay, I know you guys know this. What is the grain of any piece of wood or timber? What do you understand by grain? Stuti, Charu?
Yes, ma'am.
What is the grain of a wood?
Ma'am, ek baar question repeat kar dijiye.
What is the grain? When you say wood grain or the grain of any kind of wood, what does it mean? What is the grain of a wood? So when you see any piece of wood, you can see these lines, dark lines running through it, the veins running through it, right? Have you noticed this? Hold on. Do you see these lines? यस और नो?
यस मैम।
ओके, सो दीज लाइन्स, दीज वेन्स दैट यू सी इन वुड इज द ग्रेन ऑफ द वुड। इन अ ट्री ट्रंक, सी दीज लाइन्स, दीज रिंग्स ऑफ अ ट्री, ऑफ अ ट्रंक दैट द कंसेंट्रिक रिंग्स दैट आर फॉर्म्ड व्हेन यू सी अ क्रॉस सेक्शन ऑफ अ ट्री ट्रंक, दोज रिंग्स फॉर्म द ग्रेन ऑफ अ वुड, एंड व्हेन यू कट दैट वुड दीज आर द लाइन्स दैट यू सी। Am I not audible? Am I audible?
यस मैम।
ओके, तो द कंसेंट्रिक रिंग्स, द जो गोले दिखते हैं किसी भी, अगर पेड़ को काटोगे तो जो रिंग्स दिखती हैं वो
यस मैम।
बेसिकली किसी भी वुड का ग्रेन बनाती हैं। जब उनको वर्टिकली किसी पेड़ को कट किया जाता है तो ये लाइंस दिखती हैं, और ये लाइंस को ग्रेन बोलते हैं। तो अगर हम बोलते हैं कि यू शुड कट अलोंग द ग्रेन, तो इसका मतलब यू शुड कट दिस पीस ऑफ वुड अलोंग दिस लाइन। और अगर कहते हैं अगेंस्ट द ग्रेन, तो उसका मतलब होता है वर्टिकली, अगेंस्ट, परपेंडिकुलर टू दिस ग्रेन।
ओके मैम।
ओके, सो क्यों? तो बिकॉज पार्टिकल बोर्ड इज मेड ऑफ वुड पार्टिकल्स, नॉट एंटायर पीसेस ऑफ वुड, इसलिए यू डोंट सी ग्रेन्स इन इट। इट इज यूजली यूज्ड इन प्लेस ऑफ प्लाईवुड, एंड देन इट इज फिनिश्ड और द सर्फेस इज कंप्लीटेड विद विनियर्स और लैमिनेट्स, और इट कैन ऑल्सो बी पेंटेड। एनी क्वेश्चंस?
नो मैम।
तो लेट्स सी, लेट्स डिस्कस सॉलिड वुड इन डिटेल। सॉलिड वुड इज बेसिकली द टिम्बर और द वुड दैट यू गेट डायरेक्टली फ्रॉम बाय प्रोसेसिंग और कटिंग डाउन ट्रीज, ट्री ट्रंक्स, दैट इज सॉलिड वुड। एंड डिपेंडिंग ऑन विच ट्री इट कम्स फ्रॉम, यू कैन ईदर क्लासीफाई इट एज हार्डवुड और सॉफ्टवुड। एंड व्हेन यू से हार्डवुड, इट डजेंट मीन दैट द वुड इट इन इट सेल्फ इज मोर डेंस और समथिंग। इट इज, बट दैट्स नॉट नेसेसरली द रूल। सम हार्डवुड ट्रीज आर सॉफ्टर देन सम सॉफ्टवुड ट्रीज, विल सी दैट इन नेक्स्ट फ्यू स्लाइड्स। सो क्लासिफाइंग वुड एज ईदर अ हार्डवुड और सॉफ्टवुड कम्स डाउन टू इट्स फिजिकल स्ट्रक्चर एंड मेकअप। सो इट बेसिकली डिपेंड्स, इफ द वुड इज डिराइव्ड फ्रॉम अ ट्री विच हैज नीडल लाइक लीव्स एंड द शेप इज कोनिकल, सो ट्रीज लाइक पाइन ट्री, फर ट्री, सीडर, दीज ट्रीज, द ट्रीज दैट आर मोस्टली ग्रोन और फाउंड इन कोल्डर क्लाइमेट्स, द वुड दैट वी गेट फ्रॉम दोज ट्रीज इज कॉल्ड सॉफ्टवुड। एंड ट्रीज दैट हैव ब्रॉडर लीव्स लाइक मैंगो ट्री, नीम ट्री एंड टीक, दीज आर ऑल स्लो ग्रोइंग ट्रीज एंड वुड्स डिराइव फ्रॉम दीज इज कॉल्ड हार्डवुड एंड इट डिपेंड्स दिस क्लासिफिकेशन डिपेंड्स ऑन द इनहेरेंट प्रॉपर्टीज एंड कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ द ट्री एंड द वुड इट्स सेल्फ सो इट्स नॉट वेरी स्मार्ट टू जस्ट थिंक ऑफ हार्डवुड्स एज मोर डेंस एंड सॉफ्टवुड्स एज लेस डेंस देर इज मोर टू इट देन दैट It's generally true that yes, softwoods are more are softer, and they are less dense, and they can be cut and worked with very easily as compared to hardwoods. But there are exceptions to this. There are certain examples जो इसमें follow नहीं होते हैं. And for example, wood from yew trees is it's a soft wood because the this tree yew tree is conical it has needle like leaves and all of that the general makeup of the wood is closer to soft wood but it is harder than one of the hardwoods derived from balsa trees so how do we know which is hardwood and which is soft wood hardwood comes from angiosperm or flowering plants means trees like oak and maple or walnut which have leaves which are broader in shape so they are mostly dependent on you know a lot of sunshine they are mostly available in temperate or subtropical or tropical regions hardwood trees are Softwood trees come from gymnosperm trees, which are usually evergreen conifers. Conifer trees are, you know, conical shape. They have needles instead of leaves. Like Christmas trees. That's a very good example. So, hardwood comes from trees that usually shed all of their leaves. In you know colder temperatures and softwood comes from trees that are mostly evergreen and are conifers like pine or spruce so let's talk about hardwood hardwood trees usually grow slowly as compared to softwood trees so hardwood is expensive as compared to softwood because it is you know rarer to find and however there are exceptions to this for example gum is a hardwood that is quite cheaper as compared to most softwoods anything you want to any question you want to ask any doubts
no ma'am
okay If you have any doubt, you can stop me and ask the question. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. hardwood is durable. It doesn't easily rot or it doesn't decay, and because the grains, the rings, the density is higher. It is more dense. So. It requires low maintenance and it is more durable. Then it comes with low sap content. Sap is the viscous gel-like substance that oozes out of tree trunks when you usually cut them or mark them. Like rubber tree gives out, it oozes. Sap, which then is processed into rubber, so that thick liquid that comes out of the tree trunk when you cut it is called sap. And hardwood trees have low sap content, and so they are fire more fire resistant. एंड हार्डवुड इज मोस्टली यूज्ड फॉर वुडन फ्लोरिंग बिकॉज यू नीड फ्लोरिंग टू बी ड्यूरेबल एंड यू नीड फ्लोरिंग टू बी मोर हार्डी सो दैट व्हेन यू वॉक ऑन इट व्हेन यू नो यू पुट फर्नीचर ऑन इट एंड फर्नीचर इज स्लाइड्स अक्रॉस द वुडन फ्लोर इट डजंट गेट ईजिली स्क्रैच्ड और डैमेज्ड सो इट्स गुड फॉर दैट एंड दैट ऑल्सो मेक्स इट वेरी गुड फॉर यू फॉर यूज इन फर्नीचर हाई क्वालिटी फर्नीचर दैट इज डिजाइंड और मेंट टू बी यूज फॉर मैनी मैनी ईयर्स Hardwood flooring is also revered for its varied natural colors, styles, and
good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon, Akriti. It is revered. Revered means it is almost. It is considered of a very high quality. It is. Revered. It is held in high regard. Hardwood is held in high regard because it is available in a lot of natural colors, lots of different styles, and lots of different grains. It is also used for making furniture, but not all types of hardwood are ideal for making furniture. Can you give me a good example of a common Indian tree jiski wood is not suitable for making furniture?
अशोक
अशोक इज नॉट बिकॉज अशोक की ट्रंक इज वेरी नैरो यू कैनॉट यू हैव टू कट डाउन अ लॉट ऑफ ट्रीज एंड यू कांट गेट वेरी वाइड स्लाइसेस आउट ऑफ इट सो इट्स नॉट यूजली यूज फॉर एनी काइंड ऑफ वुड वर्क बट मैंगो ट्री आम के पेड़ की लकड़ी इज नॉट कंसिडर्ड गुड फॉर फर्नीचर मेकिंग बिकॉज इट it frays very easily it's not very dense and it's it doesn't last as long then some of the examples for hardwood are mahogany is I think one of the most distinct looking woods available in India because it is it has a very stark reddish brown burnt sienna color which gives the name to that particular color mahogany color is characterized because of this tree the color of the wood of this tree and it is one of the most popular hardwood hardwoods available in India. Mahogany wood is prized for its beauty, durability, and color, and it is mostly free of voids and pockets. Means you won't find a lot of holes or hollow parts inside these trunks because they're very dense, and the color of this wood darkens over time. Meaning, if you buy a chair made out of mahogany, so if you keep using it and keep maintaining it, polishing and buffing it over time, it will darken in color. So it gets better with age. That's why it is a very popular choice for furniture. So the color of mahogany wood is reddish brown to blood red. And it is medium in density, and it is somewhat heavy. It's not too heavy and it's not too light. It's moderately heavy. The grains, the lines that you see in this, the grains are mostly straight. And then the most common uses of for mahogany is in high-end furniture, because it is quite rare to find, and mahogany trees take a lot of time to grow, to mature. So it is only used in high-end furniture. It is used in interiors, meaning for flooring, and used for woods, sorry, doors, windows, and trims. Trims is the wooden edges or edge capping provided in wooden construction, or you know, in skirting, or maybe at the corner of the ceiling or something like that. Then how do we finish this, meaning what is the last finishing touch that you should give for this kind of wood? You have to sand it with a sealer. You have to seal it to protect it from humidity and spills and stains. Then you have walnut. Walnut is one of the most popular woods for furniture. Then the dimensional stability, meaning the structural stability, shock resistance, and strength, and the rich color are the reason behind its popularity. So it is, again, like mahogany is a very distinctly reddish brown, walnut is very distinctly like dark grayish brown. It is in color, it goes from lighter pale brown to dark chocolate brown color. See, here you can see the lighter plain pale brown color, then you can see mostly dark chocolate brown color all over, and there are dark brown streaks all through it. These streaks are the grain. Then sapwood is pale yellow or gray to nearly white. What do you mean? What does it mean when they say sapwood? Sapwood matlab, when you see a, hold on, let me show this to you. Can you see this?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now here, if you see, this outer ring is the bark of the tree, right? जिसे हिंदी में छाल बोलते हैं. This is not used for any kind of furniture or timber. Then, on the inner ring, you see a very light pale brown ring, right? This is the sapwood. The outer part of the tree trunk is the sapwood. And then this rich coffee brown core of this trunk is called the heartwood. H-E-A-R-T wood, heartwood. So because it is at the heart of the tree trunk, it's at the center, and the outer part of the tree trunk is called sapwood. So for walnut, this center heartwood is mostly chocolate brown, and this outer part is pale yellow. And you see these rings, when you cut a tree trunk for timber, you cut it headways, meaning vertically. So these rings get sliced. So when they get sliced, these parts, these rings look like grains. So the color is, as we can see, mostly chocolate brown with light pale brown streaks and dark brown streaks. And the sapwood is pale yellow or gray or almost white. Then the density of walnut is medium texture to medium texture, as in it has medium density and it is fairly lightweight. So it is also that's another reason why it's good for furniture, because you get very high quality out of this wood, but it is also lightweight. So you make good quality furniture, but it isn't extremely heavy. Then the grain, it is more moderately open grained, meaning then these that these lines are fairly straight and they very rarely meet in the center, or they very rarely intersect. That's why it's moderately open grain. And the most common uses of walnut are in high-end furniture, again because it is hardwood and it takes time to for a walnut tree to mature to the level where you can cut it or utilize it for timber. So it is quite expensive. So it is only used in high-end furniture, used for carving, and it is used for flooring accents. It's also used for musical instruments and gun stocks. Gun stocks means the head part of the gun, you know, where if it doesn't matter, it's not relevant to furniture design. Finishing is it should be finished with oil-based polyurethane. Like for mahogany, it was sanding sealer, but for walnut, you should use an oil-based polyurethane. Then comes red oak. Red oak is very rare in India. You don't find red oak trees in India, but you should know about this because it can be imported and it is very, very highly prized, even more than mahogany and walnut, because it is one of the strongest woods that can be used for any furniture or, you know, interior work. Oak trees are native to northern hemisphere. There are around 600 species of oak, both deciduous and evergreen. Oak wood is remarkably strong, heavy, and durable. It is also resistant to fungal attacks. Red oak has a red, pinkish red color, and it varies from pinkish red to blonde. Blonde means almost golden. Density is it is very dense and strong, and it is very heavy. And then grain varies. It varies from because there are almost 600 species. So depending on what species it is, the grain varies. And it has openly porous grain pattern, meaning if you notice in this image, you will see that there is in walnut, it feels as if it's almost a single piece of wood and there is no seams or no gaps in here. But in oak, you can see this kind of a texture, an open texture that you can almost feel, it's almost tangible. That's because it's openly porous. Then most common uses include furniture in cabinets because it is resistant to fungal attacks. That's why it is good for cabinets and storage, because it will protect the things, objects kept inside those cabinets. It is also used for molding, trim, flooring, paneling, and turning. Then to finish red oak, you can use a natural finish or oil, but it varies. Again, because of all the different species, it varies. Ash. Ash trees are medium to large trees that grow in most parts of the world. Ash wood feels smooth to the touch. It is durable, tough, and flexible. So far, we have talked about three. This is the fourth kind of wood we are talking about. And this is the first one that is flexible. And it has excellent nailing, screw holding, and gluing properties. Meaning, like in oak, because it is very dense and walnut is also quite medium, has medium density, so does mahogany. So what happens is it's not very easy to put a nail in it or maybe put a screw in it. But in ash wood, you can easily work with it. So it has a better workability than the rest. So carpenters love to work with ash wood because it can be easily cut, it can be easily bent and worked with. However, it produces a distinct and moderately unpleasant smell while working on it. Color of ash wood varies from light to creamy brown. This example here is creamy brown. Density is tough but flexible. It is open grained with occasional brown streaks. It is commonly used for flooring, millwork, for making boxes or crates, for baseball bats and other turned objects such as tool handles. Turned objects means turning wood is basically if you carve that piece of wood in a cylindrical manner to carve out an object. Like baseball bats are mostly cylindrical with that and narrow at the end with a sphere at that narrow end. So turning is basically you fix a piece of wood and then carve around it. Like banisters, wooden banisters are made by turning wood. So it is good for that because it is easily workable. Finishing, it can be finished in any manner that you want. Then birch wood. Birch trees are widespread in northern hemisphere. Though it is closely related to oak wood, it is much harder. Birch plywood is probably the most widely used as it is hard, stable, affordable, and readily available. The hardwood, meaning the core part of the tree trunk of birch trees, is light reddish brown, and the sapwood is nearly white. And it has a hard high density and it is medium in weight. It usually has straight or slightly wavy grain with small pores. Like this is, so far we have only seen straight grains. They're going straight in direction. And this is the first kind of wood that we've seen, this kind of swirly, wavy texture. This is the kind of texture that you guys made in basic design principles. So the most common uses for birch wood is plywood for boxes, crates, and turned objects. Again, the same thing like handles, like bats, banisters. Then for cabinets as well, because it's hard, it's in high in density. So because cabinets and cabinet doors are opened and then closed very often, so it should be any wood that is used for cabinets or storage furniture should be able to withstand a lot of physical stress. A lot of it should have anti-shock properties. Otherwise, it will start damaging, because all these grains, you're always told to maybe cut or put a nail perpendicular to the grain. Uske along kabhi nahi karna chahiye, because it is easily split. When you guys were making those cubes, basic design mein, I'm sure you guys noticed that if you try to put a nail in wood along the grain, to wo split ho jati thi. Yeah?
Yes, ma'am.
That's because of this. So any wood jo bahut soft ho and it's less dense and it is not very hard. So what happens is, when you constantly open something and then bang the wood back close, then over time it starts splitting and it starts getting damaged. So for storage furniture, you should use very dense, hard wood. And for storage furniture, you can also use wood that is heavier, because you're not going to this. It's not an everyday thing that you pick up a storage, a wardrobe or a cabinet or a cupboard and move it around. So that can be heavy. And as opposed to chairs and tables that tend to be moved around quite a lot, you can use a lighter weight wood for that. Then another uses for birch wood is for seating, meaning for chairs and sofas and all. Then millwork for furniture and interior doors. Why interior doors, not exterior doors? Because it doesn't withstand extreme temperatures very well. And then like ashwood, it can take almost all kinds of finishes. Cherry wood. Cherry wood cherry trees or maple trees are mostly native to Asia, but they're also found in Europe, North America, and North Africa. Cherry wood comes from cherry fruit tree. Cherry wood has a rich color and a smooth grain, and it is also flexible. It that makes it a good choice for furniture, and it also steams easily. So what does that mean? When you want to bend or form an arched or curved design in wood, what you do is you steam it, so that it becomes flexible, it loses it its stiffness, and then you can tie it to a formwork, whatever shape you want, and when it dries, it stays in that shape. So because it is flexible, it can, and it steams easily, it doesn't get damaged because of steaming, so that makes it very good for curved designs. Color of cherry wood is light pinkish brown when it is freshly cut, and it darkens to medium reddish brown over time. So like mahogany, see, the reddish color in mahogany, in cherry, comes from stiff in density and it is strong and has medium weight and it is moderately hard. So, and the grain is mostly straight and closed. Because the grain is closed, that's why it is smooth in texture. So if the grain is open, the natural texture of this wood will be quite rough. But because cherry and walnut and mahogany, these woods have closed and straight grain, it is quite smooth to touch. Then the most common uses for cherry wood is in cabinets, in fine furniture, flooring, interior millwork, and as veneers. It is also used in musical instruments, and it's used for paneling. And because it is flexible and it has a smooth grain, it is also good for turning wood. And then it is also good for small specialty wood items. You know, those souvenirs that you get that are carved out of wood. Those high quality specialty items are made out of cherry wood, can be made out of cherry wood. Veneer, I think by now aap logon ko pata hoga veneer kya hota hai. Veneer is basically a very thin slice of natural wood. So if you know, for somebody who cannot afford to buy mahogany or oak wood, they can buy veneers of these woods and apply it to a cheaper wood. So the outer finish, the wood doesn't have the quality of these trees, but it will look and feel like, suppose if I use a mahogany or a walnut veneer on mahogany on maybe pine wood or some soft wood, so it will look like mahogany, but it won't have the qualities of mahogany tree. Any doubts? Any questions?
No, ma'am.
Okay.
No, ma'am. No, ma'am.
Okay. So, to finish cherry wood, you can use light to natural finishes, so that it doesn't damage the color or natural grain of cherry wood. And because it is already very smooth in texture, you don't need a lot of finishes for it. Then beech wood. Beech trees are deciduous and are native to temperate Europe, Asia, and North America. Beech wood is quite durable and resistant to abrasion and shock. Because beech steam bends as readily as ash, carpenters love to work with it. It also provides an elegant and dated look to the furniture. And it is not dishwasher safe. So basically, because it is durable and resistant to abrasion, meaning its surface doesn't get damaged very easily and it can take a lot of shock. So it is good for flooring, for crates and boxes and containers that are going to be transported and that are not might not be handled very carefully. So because it is strong like that, it's used for those things. And it also steam bends very easily. It can be steamed quite well. So it is also used for curved piece of furniture like chairs or something like that. The finished product looks quite elegant. Then color of beech wood is pink to reddish brown core, and the sapwood is creamy to pink. Density is very hard and it is very heavy. Then it has mostly straight grain with a almost fine to medium uniform texture. So that means that you will not see a lot of contrast in this. It's almost quite similar all over. And the most common uses for beech wood are chair legs and backs because it can be seamed and turned and bent. And it is used for crates and pallets, railroad ties, and then flooring, food containers, toys, musical instruments, and wooden ware. But it is not dishwasher safe, so you cannot make utensils out of it. And it can be finished in any way you want. Now we come to the one of the most popular and highly regarded hardwoods in India. And teak wood is, however, trade or use of teak wood has been banned in India since 2018 or 19. So cutting down teak trees and selling that timber as a product has been banned because teak trees have been classified as endangered. So any teak wood you use should either be reclaimed or recycled from old existing teak furniture. It should be reclaimed wood. So teak, or as in Hindi we call it sagon, teak trees are tropical hardwood trees and are native to India, Myanmar, and Thailand. Teak wood is one of the hardest and most durable of all natural woods. It is resistant to rotting, sunlight, rain, frost, and snow. So this is why it is valued so much, because it doesn't rot. It can withstand sunlight, so it can be used in outdoor furniture or outdoor decking, or maybe even wooden construction. And it can withstand rain, so it's very good for construction, as a construction material. Then frost and snow, so even in colder temperatures, it will maintain its dimensional stability, making it suitable for outdoor construction and furniture. However, it is expensive and it is hard to find. But nowadays it is actually illegal to buy or use newly derived teak wood because we don't have as many teak trees in India anymore, which is quite unfortunate. Color of teak wood is a golden or medium brown in the hardwood, and it darkens with age. It is very heavy and very strong, very dense, and the grain is also quite straight, as you can see in the image, and it can be wavy or interlocked. So towards the edges, you can see it is breaking into waves or concentric, loops. Otherwise, it's mostly straight. Most common uses for teak are board building because it can withstand rain and water, and it is used for as a veneer for furniture, exterior construction, carving, and turnings. And it is best finished with wood lacquer. We will talk about all these finishes and polishes in workshop. Wooden metal workshop. So don't worry if you don't absolutely understand all of these things. We will talk about them later in the semester. I think we'll continue the rest of the hardwoods and softwoods in the next class. And thank you for now. We will continue the same topic in the next session. Any doubts?
No, Mom.
Okay. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, Mom.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, Mom.